The first thing I touched on is, in a month, I assume in a month's time you're going to be going for a job, yes? Going for jobs, is that right? So the first thing I want to say is prepare yourself for job interviews. Prepare yourself for the recruiters. I know when I was at Macleay, they had job seeking skills. No one teaches that. No companies teach that. No organisations teach that. Like, if I was Prime Minister of this country, I would make it a thing where it was compulsory to have job seeking skills, not at college or university, I'd have it at school. Because it's so important. You guys are going to be competing with four or five or six people when you go for that job in November, December. Don't wait till February, March. You know, start putting it out there now. The recruiters are fantastic these days. So I'd actually recommend, you guys are paid good money to go to Macleay College. So you guys have got, like when I speak to Macleay College people, I think that's great. These people must come from a good family. That's what I think. They come from a good family whose family's been prepared to put them through some good training. So I think that's a start. They've obviously got good morals and, you know, we all stuff around a young age, but I put that person higher than the next person who maybe went to TAFE at Greystones. Okay? So you guys need to get prepared for these opportunities. Recruiters are looking for good quality people. But you've got to find what it may be that you're interested in doing next year and go see those recruiters and say, man, I'm coming out of Macleay College in a month's time. I've done this work experience. I really want to be considered for certain roles. And get onto it early. Like one sort of person I don't employ are when people come to me and they say, I haven't really, you know, I stopped my last job 3 months or I left college 6 months ago. I'm like, well, what have you done in that time? You know, people are looking for people who are active on the front foot, who aren't reactive but are proactive, because that says something about their attitude. That says something about this person that they want to achieve. They want to get organised. They want to have a job when the new year ticks around. Be prepared. Presentation. So many people get this wrong. Like, if you saw the photo of my team, I wouldn't say we only employ attractive people, because that's not true. But we employ well-presented people. People who take care of themselves in terms of grooming. People who take care of themselves in terms of how they dress and how they present. Because in my industry, and in most industries, people will decide whether they like you or not like you literally in the first couple of minutes of meeting you, without even saying that much. So your body language and your presentation says a lot about you individually. Now, you've been at college, but for the guys, time to really get serious. There's some people who've walked into my office and I'll walk past reception, they won't know I'm the director, and I'll look at them and I'll know straight away if we're interested or not. So think of that as you wish, but I can assure you the employers that are going to be looking for the good quality people are going to want well-presented, smell good, feel good, look good, take care of things like that, because you guys are going to be representing their organisation. And you are competing, I stress, you're going to be competing with four or five or six other applicants, and you want to put yourself in that box seat to say, hey, listen, pick me. Pick me. I was on time. I know about your company. I've done some research on your company. Like, it was great when I spoke to Pete before. He goes, mate, you guys are doing great. I said, how do you know? He goes, mate, I saw your ads in the paper a few weeks ago. Now, that's a very impressive. If a young person came to my company and said, I'd love to work with Bresic Whitney, and I say, why? And they go, because we pulled out the Sydney Morning Herald and we saw 10 pages of your company. We want to be involved with that company. I go, man, that person's done research. They're well prepared. I've got a good feeling about them. I've got a good feeling about them. Where can we slot them in? So get prepared. Be well presented. I don't need to spend much time talking about this. And for many of your parents, they no doubt would have entrusted or, you know, built this in you as a child and as a teenager and as you grew up. You can't do well in any business unless you work hard. You know, I know for the first 4 or 5 years in real estate, I wasn't the smartest. I certainly didn't have the most skills, but I worked damn hard, real hard. So much so that I had to sacrifice certain parts of my life. I still had friends, I still went to clubs, but there was a lot of sacrifices that I did to want to get ahead. So understand that I say that you can all be successful with these things that I've mentioned, but you've got to understand it's going to be a lot of hard work. In fact, I actually think that as you get established, certainly in my industry, getting established and getting well known is a big thing. So a lot of effort and hard work has to be made into that point. I think the hardest part of real estate is the first 3 or 4 or 5 years, because no one knows you. So you need to work damn hard to be recognised and have a profile. Once you've got a profile, people just ring you to list their home and sell their home, and you get mentioned in the paper and so on. Understand that, have a break, you know, enjoy and celebrate the fact that you've graduated, but when you start, it's on. And if you want to succeed, and it's you and you only determine your success and failure. Not Macleay College, not your mother and father, not your friends, and not your employer. You and you only. Take responsibility for it. You want to be successful, you can. But you got to work hard. You got to get those right, you got to get the right opportunities. Passionate attitude. And I love talking about passionate attitude, because I'm very passionate about what I do. And this is why I say, you guys now have the opportunity to go work for certain companies in a certain industry. For God's sake, if there's only one thing I can leave with you, find something that you enjoy doing. Because I can tell you now, and I know people who enjoy cleaning. I've got cleaners who love cleaning. So I know my barista, where I get my coffee every day, loves pouring coffees. Fantastic. I know some people who love real estate and make a lot of money selling real estate. It's very difficult to do good in what you're doing if you don't love and enjoy what you do. And you guys are the primes of your career, because you haven't wasted 15, 20, 25 or 30 years. You can make the decision now. I see a lot of people who are 30, 35, 40, 45, very confused about what they want to do. And that's okay, because they can turn it around, but they have to make some significant changes. I was very lucky. People say, Ivan, you're 33, shit, it's getting on. I was given, I used to say I was 29. People say, Ivan, you're 33, you've got 2 real estate offices, you employ 75 people. How have you done that so soon? I said, pretty simple. I went to Macleay College. I worked part-time real estate when I was at Macleay College. I was 17 and a half when I started. I entered the workplace working for John McGraw at 18 and a half. I've actually been in real estate for 15 years. So I started very young. But a lot of people can't understand. A lot of my friends went overseas for 12 months and travelled, went backpacking. And that was a sacrifice. And I remember seeing them off or going to the farewell. And they were so excited to go. And I was like, well, I have to go show properties for lease tomorrow in Paddington. Now, I remember a lot of parties being on a Friday night. I'd still go, but I'd have to, you know, pull up stumps a bit early, just so I was on the ball the next day. So you guys are in the prime, you know, position of your careers. You're about to go to the marketplace. You're about to decide who you're going to work for, and you should get excited about that. Get really excited. You guys have got a bit of a head start on other girls and guys out there at the moment, I reckon. And this is coming from me, an employer. I've employed 3 or 4 people from Macleay College to Bresic, Whitney over the years. But you guys got a slight head start on them. This college is, you know, it's well regarded in the marketplace. But now it's up to you guys. They're not going to do it for you. They've done it for the last 12 months. They're going to help you get your diploma. But now you guys are out there in the big wide world of the workplace. Make the right decisions. Just on that passion and attitude thing, I have people come to me from other companies and they've got certain skills. So I can always teach a young, our company can always teach a young person who's got the right passion and attitude skills. We can teach them how to take a phone call. We can teach them how to negotiate. We can teach them how to show a property for sale. But you can't teach a good attitude. You can't teach a good passion.